Hello. Since 2005, the EU has put in place an emission trading system, short ETS, to incentivize emission reduction from European industry. The European Commission has tabled a legislative proposal to reform the system for the post-2020 period. Today, environment ministers meet in Luxembourg to discuss this ongoing European ETS reform. With me now, Markus Beirer, Director General of BusinessEurope. Markus, some stakeholders say the EU's ETS does not work and is not the right instrument. What is BusinessEurope's position?
Well, BusinessEurope is a very strong supporter of the ETS, the emission trading system, because we think at the end of the day, a market-based system is the best way to achieve the necessary reduction of our carbon footprint in a cost-effective way. So therefore, we support the system. At the same time, of course, it's important to more and more go in the direction of a level global playing field for our industry. We were a strong supporter of the deal made in Paris. It's very important that other regions in the world are now more committed to our common goal to reduce greenhouse gas emission.
So what are your top three priorities for the European ETS reform?
The most important one is to make sure that we have enough free allowances available for the best in class. So what do I mean? The idea is that those who are investing the most in carbon reduction, those are doing best, those are the cleanest production sites in Europe, and then automatically mostly in the world, that they should get 100% free allowances. So the best 10% should not be further cut. And in the current system, this is not possible. So what we need to do is we need to change the ratio between the so-called auctioning, which means money going into the pockets of the national ministers of finance, and the share which is available for free allowances for the best performing companies must be moved. Because it's not possible that we don't have enough free allowances for the best in class. This is number one. Number two is we need realistic benchmarks. This is very technical, but what it means is we cannot have a flat rate which is automatically in a linear way reducing this benchmark every year. Because it means that even the good performing plants will not be able to do so, because plant managers already do a great job to keep the efficiency of plants on a certain level. If you make it harder year by year, this is simply not realistic. And the third point is the indirect costs. This means the cost imposed on companies, on plants, by the high electricity costs, thanks to carbon costs. This is unavoidable, but it needs to be compensated. At the time being, this is happening in a very fragmented way across the continent. So what we need is a harmonized system which makes sure that we compensate the companies in order to keep them in Europe.
So today the environmental ministers meet in Luxembourg to discuss a reform. What is your message to the ministers?
Our message is that BusinessEurope and the whole European business community are very committed to making this ETS reform a success. But they need to make sure that it works for all sectors. So this means on the one side, it has of course to work for the energy sector. They need a price signal in order to motivate them and ensure them to invest in low carbon technologies and to continue in investing there. At the other hand, it also needs to work for the energy intensive and trade exposed industry, which has tough fights across the world. And it needs to work for them as well. And this means we need to have enough free allowances available, and we need to make sure that we have a system which protects against the so-called carbon leakage, or like I prefer to call it, the investment leakage. Because what we need to achieve is that our companies reduce carbon emissions in Europe and do not add to emissions outside Europe.